Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I would like to wish you a really happy new year because this is the first vlog that I'm delivering of 2015. And I want to wish my entire community a really prosperous and happy and healthy new year in 2015 as we move ahead. Today, as I was taking a look back kind of at the year that was, I wanted to pick one thing that surprised the heck out of me in this journey of growing my YouTube channel and building a business out of YouTube for this vlog, for growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers. And when I look back at the year that was, the thing that just gobstopped me and has completely surprised me is the community's engagement in Patreon, in the community-funded, the crowdfunding site that is now generating a fairly substantial amount of revenue as far as I'm concerned. And I think as the year goes ahead, will become my most significant revenue source. So we're going to take a look today, a revisit, a remix on Patreon on Dotto Tech. You know, I began this whole project, growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers, and actually this whole YouTube project of building a community on YouTube to see if I could recreate the success that I'd had on television, to see if YouTube could indeed support a content creator and could be the basis for moving ahead. And I didn't have any preconceived notions about where I was going to make money and how I was going to make revenue. I knew there was opportunities out there to do digital products and sell courses, to get advertising revenue from AdSense and other things, consulting, other things would come along as a result of creating authority through a YouTube channel and building a community through the YouTube channel. And all of those have generated revenue, some more successful than others. And we'll talk about them as the year goes on. Certainly the digital products are doing quite well. And we'll be talking a little bit about the digital products as they relate to Patreon. But the thing that shocked the heck out of me this year was when I launched a Patreon campaign. Now, Patreon is crowdfunding for content creators. It's like Kickstarter for content creators. So what happens is you basically go to a community and you say, help me create my content by financially supporting me, and I'll give you some perks. There'll be some benefits attached to being a part of this community. And so for me, what this became was a place that people could come, and the pitch that I put out at the beginning was, if you help by giving me a little bit of money, then I don't have to spend all my time looking for advertising revenue, and I can create more and better content. And people responded quite well. We launched the Patreon campaign a little over 6 months ago, maybe 7 months ago, and immediately we had some traction, and people were saying, yeah, I get that, Steve. And they were giving me $1 a month and $5 a month, very small amounts of money, which basically said to them that they were supporting my endeavors. And as a content creator, it was awesome. It was a really affirming feeling to have people saying and actually paying money. And when the money came in, when the first month ended, and I think $350 or so came into my account, I was like, wow, that is so cool. But I didn't really, even at that point there, say, you know, this is going to be the main pillar. This is going to be where I'm going to make most of my money moving ahead. Because I didn't really have a sense of what the difference was and what a patronage site, a crowdfunding site like this, could represent. As the year moved on, it slowly increased until the point that I looked at it, and I don't know what caused me to make this change, but as I was looking at it, I thought, you know what I want to do is I guess in September when I created a really nice new little course, my Evernote Made Easy course, when I created that course, I said, you know, I should really make that course available to the people who are supporting me on Patreon. So at the $10 level of patronage, of people who are supporting me at $10 a month, this was starting in October, I think I put it out. I said, hey, if you're a patron, thank you for your support. And I've got this new course that I developed. It's normally $97, but as a part of the patronage, I will give it to you for free. And people responded immediately. All of a sudden, I had people upgrading their account, and new people were signing up. And everybody I started at the end of my sales webinars talking about it. Now, there's a two-edged sword here, because I was telling people they could buy it for $97, or they could join me on Patreon at $10 a month, and they could get access to the same content. So people immediately said, well, what happens if I just sign up for a month and then I unsubscribe? Do I get the course still? Of course you get the course still. If you're the sort of person that wants to do that, then I wasn't going to worry about those sorts of, about plugging all of the loopholes. I guess it's a pretty big loophole, but I wasn't going to worry about plugging it, because I think the idea of community means that there's a certain type of person that's going to be attracted to it. And if you're going to do that, you probably weren't going to be a member of my community anyways. So, and besides, I also offer a money-back guarantee on the course, so you could have always asked for your money back anyways, and you would have got your money back. So there are ways to get the course for free if you really want to. Frankly, if somebody wants the course for free and they're going to do one of those things, I'd rather they just write and say, Steve, give me the course for free, please, or I'll just do one of these other things, and then I'll just save you the trouble and send you the course for free. But having said that, the idea of community is what was important here. As I started to see more and more traction, as people started to purchase the course or jump onto the Patreon at that $10 level, I saw the number increasing pretty dramatically. And then we launched another course. I did one with Mike Vardy. And poor Mike Vardy, he jumps on and he helps me build this Task Apps Made Easy course. And then people, I included it in my patronage because I didn't think that it was going to be, you know, it was going to be that huge in Patreon. I thought, you know, other people were going to buy it. But indeed, a lot of people jumped on that as well. Even though they could get the bundle for $149, people still chose to get the course a lot on Patreon. And Mike includes it in his patronage, is on his Patreon site as well. But regardless, as this moved along, a shift happened in my mind, in the way that I look at things. And I recognized that Patreon was, I was basically able, with this Patreon support, with including these courses in Patreon as a perk at the $10 level, I had created a sort of a membership system. You know how if you sign up, I could have quite easily taken all of the, my content and on my own website created a membership site where you pay me $10 or $20 or $30 a month and you get access to all of the content at a membership site and you just give the money directly to me. And that those work well. Lots of people use those and they're very, very successful. But there's a psychological relationship that happens then in the fact that if you join the membership site, you are my customer. You're purchasing content from me. Keep that in mind, and then think about what happens at Patreon. At Patreon, the people come in with an attitude of, I'm supporting you. I'm not so much paying for what you're going to give me as supporting you to create new content in the future. That's the philosophy behind Patreon. It's about content creation. So when they get the stuff in the past, it's a perk as opposed to something that they're purchasing from you. So people don't feel like they're your customer, but instead they feel like they're your patron. They are supporting you. And the feeling from me is the same. It's not so much you're my customer, but you're a supporter of my community. And I look at it, there's just a slightly different philosophical feel to it. Does that make sense? I think it does if you stop and think about it. So started to recognize this. It takes a while sometimes, but the light started to dawn in November. And all through November, I was thinking, okay, how am I going to approach Patreon moving ahead into 2015? And it crystallized in my mind of what I should be doing and how perhaps you can be looking at using Patreon moving ahead. And what I decided to do was I decided to take Patreon and I decided to push my courses as much as possible, all of this new content that I was going to create, into the Patreon community. There was already several hundred people in the community, so there are people that were going to appreciate that content coming down the pipe to them, A, but it was also, it seems to be a very easy sell to ask people for $10 or $20 a month to support you on Patreon, as opposed to ask them for $100 or $200, $300 or $400 to purchase a course outright. So that was the philosophy that I thought about moving ahead. Now, there are a couple of caveats to that. When I launch a brand new course, I don't think that it should be available to the patrons at Patreon immediately. I think there should be a sales. There should be a window, 6 weeks maybe, where I can launch it and I can actually sell it. And I can include some extra little perks to people that are selling and then make it available to people on Patreon. That's still something that I'm working out in my mind, but I think that that's a reasonable way to approach things, especially some of my higher-end courses that I'm developing around content publishing, around YouTube publishing, that take a lot of time and effort to produce the course. There should be a time that I can sell it I can sell it as a fixed product as well. So that's what I'm doing moving ahead, is looking at Patreon as the potential best revenue source for me. I am basically planning an editorial schedule now of releasing products into Patreon. So what I had to do is I had to make some decisions now. Patreon has, you can see the numbers here. So we're now a little bit over 6 months into it, and we're sitting at nearly $2,700 a month in revenue already off of it. So this is not insignificant as far as I'm concerned. And if this has grown this fast, you know, if we've grown by $2,500 in about 6 months, if I can do that same growth rate by the end of 2015, you can see how this could be a significant part of any independent producer's income. So that's my plan. So having looked at that, I had to take a look at this, which is the pledge structure, you know, exactly what you get for what you give. And I wanted to, I've always wanted to reduce the number. And I'm actually a little bit stuck with this idea because I'd like to get rid of this $5 a month pledge and just have $1 a month and then let people add be anywhere between $1 and $10 and not actually have a fixed number like this, just to, so there's one less thing for them to look at. But I don't know how to do that with the existing people. It's something that I'll have to talk to the people at Patreon about. But once we hit this $10 a month level, that's where real money, as far as I'm concerned, starts to come into me. And that's where the really valuable perks should start to go out to the patrons. So the so what I've decided I'm doing is I've tiered my content because I have two different audiences. I have you folks who are the audience that's interested in webcasting and podcasting and in screencasting and YouTube publishing and in social media and internet marketing, which is what this vlog is really all about. And then I have my productivity audience. Now, some of you cross over, but then I have my productivity audience that's interested in Gmail and Evernote and iPhones and that sort of stuff. So what I've decided to do is to take all of my productivity-based courses, the Evernote courses that I'm doing, the Task Manager courses, any courses I do in that space, and make that available to the people who are at the $10 a month level, because those courses are all going to be $97, and that's what I perceive as good value for those courses, and so I'm going to slot those in as perks at the $10 a month level. I think people are willing to spend a little bit more money if they can make money. And the things that I'm teaching in the YouTube course that I'm creating and the webinar courses that I'm developing right now, that's going to help people create revenue themselves. So I'm going to set up at the $20 a month level access to those services. So if you want to take my YouTube course, if you want to take my webinar course, if you're sponsoring me at $20 a month, you'll get access to those courses. And then if people want both, we will have a tier at $25 a month, which basically gives people access to all of the courses. I think that this ultimately is going to really accelerate the revenue into my channel and into my enterprise because of the philosophical feeling of support rather than purchasing. And it's a nice, reasonable dollar value that people can handle without breaking the bank that they get a lot of good value from. They're going to know that they're going to be getting good courses coming down the pipe. Plus, they get early access to other videos and other things. But primarily, it's all about the courses. So this is a little philosophically different. And what this does for me as a content creator is it takes off a lot of pressure. Because here's one of the challenges with just being an information product, the selling information products, which is the model most internet marketers are following, is it's feast or famine. You have to be either you're in development or launch all the time. But by that I mean either you're building a new course and figuring out what your audience wants and then selling that course or building it up to the point where you can launch it and then sell it, or you're in that sales cycle where you're selling it. But then between the two, when you're not selling, promoting a course actively, your revenue is going to dry up pretty significantly. So creating a consistent passive income stream is really what Patreon can bring to the table. And that's exactly what I see starting to happen. As I say, this was a complete surprise to me. I fully expected Patreon to be a nice aside to kind of generate the same amount of revenue as maybe AdSense was generating, but it's already past my AdSense revenue already just 6 months in. So it's also seems to be far more scalable than I might have believed at the beginning. So once I've launched a product now, in future webinars when I'm promoting it, I'll be doing less selling of the product and more pushing people towards Patreon and getting them into the community. And at that point there, it takes a lot of the pressure off because every month we have money coming in. So that's what's happening with the business side of Patreon. I think it's grown to the point now where all content creators have to take a good, long, hard look at it. You know, YouTube is. They have their own content creators model, kind of a tip jar that they've been putting forward to compete with Patreon. At least I believe it's going to compete with Patreon. Unfortunately for me, they've authorized me for the program, sent me an invitation to the program. When I replied, they said, oh, thanks for your interest, but it's not available in your country. Apparently Canada doesn't have it yet. So they will let me know when it's available. So some of you might actually have it already. So if you do, please let us know. Maybe you can comment down below exactly what's happening with it and let us know what's going on. I hope you found this interesting today. I know it seems very narcissistic as I talk about me and how I'm producing this content. But really, we've been using the Dotto Tech channel as a testing bed. And it's the only one that I have control over. So I have to basically talk about me if I'm going to show you what we've been doing and what we've learned. But what I have learned, the biggest lesson from 2014, is crowdfunding is definitely worth taking a good, long, hard look at and getting your head around the difference between selling a product and being basically the mentor of a community, and what the difference is for your customers from being an audience to customers, now to being patrons, to being supporters of your community, of your channel. That's a pretty profound shift, and it's one that could indeed carry you forward business-wise as you move ahead. This channel here, or this video series here, is brought to you by Patreon. I make it ad-free, and it's supported by the community. If you are interested in taking a look at my Patreon page, I encourage you to have a look. The link is here. Also, don't forget to, of course, subscribe to this channel and sign up for our newsletter for all of our upcoming webinars, as we're going to be concentrating really hard this year on webinars, teaching people how to create webinars, which I think is probably the best way to grow your market, to actively grow your market. Obviously YouTube is a big part of the entire growth process, but it fits very nicely with the whole webinar process, and creating an event is such a powerful thing. I think webinars are the way it's going to be going this coming year. With that, I'm done. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.